Schizophrenia is a severe mental disorder that has been fascinating scientists for hundreds of years because we just don't understand it. But now we may have finally found the root of this devastating disorder. It starts when the brain is forming in the womb. Schizophrenia causes people to hallucinate, have a distorted view of reality, and experience extremely disordered thinking. Brain function can be so badly affected that it's disabling. Symptoms usually appear in adolescence or young adulthood. And while some research has suggested a link between schizophrenia, drug usage, and trauma, it has never been well understood. Because the symptoms appear later in life, researchers have long assumed the root cause is a mix of genetics, brain chemistry, and environmental factors. Environmental being your upbringing, not the air you breathe. In the past, patients have long been misdiagnosed, mistreated, sometimes even being jailed. But new technology has helped us understand what's really going on. Medical imaging has shown that a patient with schizophrenia has a brain and central nervous system that look different than an unaffected patient's. There are hundreds of genetic mutations that might cause schizophrenia, but scans all show affected brains share the same faulty genomic pathway. It's clear from mounting evidence that schizophrenia is a brain disease. Armed with this information, researchers turned to consider how that one pathway can be consistently faulty among so many patients. And they're using a little mad science-sounding technique. They grew mini brain structures in a lab. Specifically, they grew cerebral organoids, recreating the first phases of human brain development using skin cells from test subjects. Four of these subjects had schizophrenia and three did not. The cells grew into tiny organs that mimicked brains in the first 12 weeks of pregnancy. And the mini brains grown from schizophrenic patients showed critical malformations in the cortex, the part of the brain that controls things like memory, attention, and cognition. The cells that become neurons weren't distributed normally. The mini brains show there would be too few mature neurons in the cortex for normal functionality when the fetus becomes a full-grown adult. This result suggests that schizophrenia likely starts in the first trimester. The cells that develop into neurons don't connect the same way in a schizophrenic cortex as they do in an unaffected one. If your brain was a computer, a brain with schizophrenia would be, to quote a source, improperly wired. There would be only so much you could do from the outside to fix it, which is why schizophrenia is so hard to treat and it seems impossible to prevent. But knowledge is power, and researchers are now starting to look at schizophrenia treatment with prenatal care, drugs, and supplements so brains have a better chance of forming with the right neural pathways. Thanks for watching, and if you want more science in your day, please subscribe. We're still learning about how our brain works, and if you're curious, check out Trace's video about the giant neurons that could explain where consciousness comes from. Fun fact, their first recorded case of schizophrenia was in 1550 BCE in one of the oldest Egyptian medical texts, the Ebers Papyrus.